BBC Radio Scotland.
Up, wake me up. The Rolling Stones are back with their first album of new material in 18 years, rocking through their seventh decade with tracks like Brown Trousers, Jumping Jack Rash, Sulpidine for the Devil, Paint It Magnolia, and I Can't Get No Circulation. Mick, Keith, and the mildly less crinkly new guys tell it like it is for octogenarian hip cats on tunes like You Can't Always Get What You Want When You Forget What It Is You Came In To Get In The First Place. The Rolling Stones' new album, available on CD, vinyl, download, streaming, Blu-ray, 78 and Edison Wax Cylinder.
Yes, get in there. We're going to Europe.
How? Did Scotland qualify?
No idea. Prestwick have just finally sorted air traffic control.
The next response is from the First Minister... Sorry. Nicola Sturgeon.
Let me be clear, Presiding Officer. I welcome the opportunity to offer my support to the current First Minister's plans to tackle poverty. And furthermore, I would...
Would the owner of a beige campervan registration number ND2SNP please remove it from the front of the building?
I will be back in 1 minute. Peter, honey bun, I told you to park in a proper parking bay.
A new online gambling craze is sweeping Scotland. Are you one of the many giving it a go?
Okay, let's do it. I'm going all in, I think.
Go for it. The rewards could be huge this time.
Oh, but it's all gone wrong in the past.
That's right, but this time's different. Our latest online gambling obsession isn't poker and it isn't horse racing. It's...
booking flights to Germany, summer 2024.
Feel the thrill, the hope, the uncertainty. Will you be part of the roar of the Tartan Army cheering the team to victory? Or end up sitting in a damp Dusseldorf hostel watching a 0-0 draw between Albania and Luxembourg?
Okay, I'm going to go for it. Book.
Booking flights for the Euros, because this time we are definitely going to qualify. Right, guys? No refunds, no excuses, no second thoughts, even if you have witnessed Jude Bellingham in action up close. Excuse me, what's going on in that room over there?
Oh, that's just the Freddie Mercury auction.
Lot number 14. The vest Freddie wore at Live Aid. Do I hear a 1-0?
1-0.
2-0.
2-0.
3-0.
3-0.
4-0. 5-0, 6-0, 7-0, 8-0.
4-0. 5-0, 6-0, 7-0, 8-0.
9-0. Sold. All right.
Okay, good. Guys, thanks for attending this, you know, government meeting. Yes, I'm the First Minister, but, you know, it's a broad tent and, well, you know, anybody can chip in at any time. Kate Forbes, would you, you know, agree?
Some would say good luck running this government when you couldn't get the trains to run on time. But my opinion is for my own conscience, and I'll back you in the current circumstances, for now.
Okay, that's good. Something to work with there. And going forward, as a team, this is a good time to, you know, highlight what we've recently achieved.
Bzz, Patrick Harvey, Minister for Compostable Bin Bags. Like what?
Okay, good question. Well, there's our plans for government. Lots of, you know, new ideas.
Bzz, no new money.
That'll come. We'll set our objectives first and then we finance them. We steady the ship and then we set sail on a, you know, positive course.
Accentuate the positive. Yay, eh?
That's it, Lorna Slater, that's it. Your bottle deposit return scheme was a roaring... you know, theoretical success, one of the many of these past few months.
Would you kindly care to name another?
Oh, God, another. Kate, you remember the triumph of the King's visit to Edinburgh, the national service of thanksgiving and, dedication.
Bzz, the Greens didn't dedicate. Bzz, I was outside protesting, shouting, "Give the King a dinghy." Anyone sat inside was a sook. Bzz. Bzz. Boo.
Boo.
Boo,
eh? Positively boo.
Okay, that's good. On some issues we can, you know, agree to disagree.
Bzz, disagree to agree.
Okay, a mix of disagreement and agreement. Internal debate within government is healthy.
Do we agree some of us can express disagreement about the Bute House Agreement?
Bzz, you dissing us Greens?
Some say urban environmentalists don't share the sensible vision of those of us who actually care about rural communities. Naming no names, pointing no elbows.
Bzz, who are you talking to?
Okay, guys, relax, please. A combination of agreement and disagreement is something that we can all agree on. A fresh start as we move towards another, you know, fresh start. Are we all in agreement?
No. Yes.
Good. In conclusion, it's currently inconclusive. Something to build on there. Now go out there and make Scotland agree or, you know, disagree with you. Yeah?
You join me here outside Scotland's legendary Arches venue, which is to restart hosting dance music events after an eight-year absence. The news is said to bring a welcome boost to Glasgow's nighttime economy. UK Government Secretary Michael Gove had this to say.
Here we flipping go. Levelling up? I'm levelling my booty up to the dance floor to shake my tail feathers all night long.
Attention, attention. HMP Greenock, a prison break is in progress. I repeat, a prison break is in progress.
Ma'am, I can't see anyone trying to escape.
I'm aware of that. There is a man clinging to the underside of a food truck attempting to break into the prison, indicated he would rather be here than in Paisley.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Howdy doody, big labour. Welcome to Anas's Alba. Angela Rayner, I've seen you on the TV giving TLC to the TUC. Cracking line, by the way. Tory levelling up is a sham and a scam. Hot damn, that's my kind of jam, Sam.
Thank you, I think, Anas. It is crucially crucial that we discuss our new deal for working people.
Hit me. I'm totally into our new deal. Like I've been into every single newfangled thing Big Labour have introduced and has tanked these past 10 years. And now we're new Labour. It makes sense we've got a new deal. Smelling box fresh.
Exactly. And since you mentioned New Labour, I would like to introduce someone who has been assisting Sakia with our new strategy, Sir Tony Blair.
Nay way, man. Sir Charles Anthony Linton Blair. I do declare, TB in the gaff.
Gosh, hello, Anas. Thrilled to meet you.
Nay kidding. Anjo, this is a total honour. 25 years ago, I had T-Dogs posted up on my wall to inspire me.
Because you too wanted to be a Labour Prime Minister?
No, because I wanted to qualify as a dentist and make everyone's chompers as sparkling as Tony Blair's. You've still got it, by the way, Sir T. Check the tusks, man. It's like staring at a total eclipse. Didn't he look? Fetch my shades, Angie. That is the grin that shaped the win and papped the Tories in the bin. Am I right?
Crumbs. Thanks.
I can't look at you without thinking Labour's greatest ever Prime Minister, because you were the geezer that set up everything for Gordon Brown to be that thing. Now, how come you're here, T-Man? Lucrative overseas public speaking gig fall through?
We and Tony believe that Scotland can play a crucial part in new Labour's new plans for new government.
Ah, gotcha, Anjo. So, TB is here on the hunt for WMDs, Westminster member dudes. And this time you might find some. New Labour can be hoaching with tartan talent, bright young darlings that can be the new Alistair darlings. Then me and Sir Kay can team up on a cross-border collab that's hotter than Calvin Harris and Sam Smith.
Ideal. So, you are backing new Labour.
Aye, and if it goes down the stank, I'll back new Labour. Great to meet an icon like yourself, T-Bone, and see those teeth in the flesh. Hit your hallelujah, Anjo, and tell the boss to floss.
coming up on BBC One Scotland, a new season of Who Do You Think You Are? In this special one-off series, following on from Scotland's 3-1 defeat to England, players Angus Gunn, Shay Adams and Scott McTominay research their family trees to see if their Scottish grannies were actually from Coventry after all.
Hello and welcome to episode 1 of the Realistic Mindfulness Podcast. Take a deep breath. Now imagine you're lying on a beach and the waves are gently lapping at the shore. Your mind may want to drift, for example, to the fact that you lent Davy that tent about 2 years ago when he was going to Blairathal and he's still not got it back to you. But if that thought does arise, then just return to the breath and focus on the breeze. Ah, the cool breeze. Does Davy even remember that it was you that lent him it? It's been 2 full years. Yeah, you didn't have plans to go camping, but it's the principle. It's nice to have the option. Breathe out. Just scan the body with awareness. Start with the toes and slowly work upwards. How long is too long to leave it before it's you that's the annoying one for asking for your own tent back? Surely you're well within your rights. He only lives 5 minutes away, and how many times have you seen him in that 2 years? Hunters of times. Sure, you've still got his Band of Brothers box set, but that is not a fair swap, and you don't even think he's got a DVD player in the new house. And in through the nose. And what if you fancy going camping? I think you do, actually. I think you fancy going camping tonight. And Davy's bang out for hogging the tent for so long. Go to Davy's and out and sort this out once and for all. It is not on. But before you do, take one final big exhale, 2, 3. Now get round there pronto and fight for your tent.
All rise, you're watching The Sunday Show featuring stood-up me, Martin Geisler, and sat-down Fiona Stalker in our radio studio.
Good morning, Martin. Yes, indeedy, indeedy-do.
Amid accusations of espionage at Holyrood, a new reworking of John Buchan's classic spy novel is to be set in the back streets of Edinburgh city centre. It's called The 3,339 Steps.
Sylvester Stallone has met the Pope. It's believed the Holyrood actor asked Pope Francis for forgiveness for making Expendables 4.
That's three hail buffs before bedtime for you, young man. Two octopuses have been spotted walking on a beach in Newquay, Wales. An observer said it was very romantic to see them walking hand in hand. In hand, in hand, in hand, in hand, in hand, in hand.
Jack Whitehall has become a father. His daughter starts work on their new television series on Monday.
The drug dealer known as Mr. Nice starts his prison sentence this week. He'll be serving time along with his acquaintances, Mr. Innocent, Mr. Alibi, and Mr. Honest Judge at Wesley Mee. Ofcom have warned ITV about showing violent scenes without accurate descriptions before the watershed. This comes after a bone-crunching headbutt by a South African rugby player on a Scottish opponent was somehow called a fair challenge by the TMO.
In Brussels, Ryanair chief Michael O'Leary was splattered by 2 cream pies. He won't be pressing charges, but the protesters will be hit with an additional access fee for excess cake in the face.
The incident is now being known as the Great Irish Boof-Off. Big thanks to you, Fiona. Let's do this. You're watching The Sunday Show. Set controls to boof.
Boof!
OK, Peaky Blinders. Birmingham's bankrupt. We need to raise 760 million. Sharpish.
How do we do that then? Shankings? Hold-ups?
No. We'll go round the pubs holding out our silly peaky caps. Plenty room for that kind of dosh.
Stuck in a rut? It's time you started thinking about running. Not actually running, just thinking about running.
I am serious about thinking about running. I invested in a fitness tracker, proper jogging shoes and all the full-on lycra. That's what I wear when I'm thinking about running. I've never actually run anywhere, but I feel better than ever.
Thinking about running has been scientifically proven to boost your ego and sense of self-importance without ever breaking a sweat.
Now I've started thinking about running, I'm going to think about how I might think about putting in for a marathon next year. I've bookmarked the website, my phone and everything. I genuinely think I might think about doing it.
And unlike actual running, you can do thinking about running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Now that's endurance.
I subscribed to Runner's World magazine. I like to hold it up when I'm on the bus so people can see that I'm really thinking about running.
Thinking about running. Don't just do it. Think it.
You're watching Sunday with Laura Koonsberg with me, Lulu Koonsberg. In our top story, Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has accused outside forces of trying to undermine British democracy. Earlier, he said this to moi.
Laura, I simply won't let anyone destroy our country's proud democratic traditions.
So speaks the man who became Prime Minister thanks to the support of 0.0004% of voters. Joining me now is Conservative Deputy Prime Minister Penny Mordaunt. Punny, what was the reaction when you recently described the city of Glasgow as like the Victorian times and riddled with ancient diseases such as rickets?
Well, Laura, Jacob Rees-Mogg found my description charming as it reminded him of his own childhood in the 1850s. He now wants to move there.
Scotland?
No, Laura, the 1850s.
So, Pinu, you have nothing against Scotland?
No, I love to visit the place, and we, the Conservative Party, are set to release funds to finally solve the mystery of the Loch Ness Monster.
Nessie?
Yessie. We got the idea after our government granted new licences to drill in the North Sea for oil and gas, even though we hinted before the referendum in 2014 that oil had all but run out.
And so you feel the Tories are best equipped to find things in deep Scottish water which have apparently completely vanished.
Exactly.
Penny Mordaunt. Thanks.
We're here at Holyrood, where the debating chamber has a new clock and a new time limit. Now, when an MSP has spoken for too long, the presiding officer can do this.
Forsooth, 'tis I, Alexander Cole, Hamilton, triple monikered Caledonian commander of the Liberal Democrats. And lo, I do sympathise with the presiding officer at Holyrood, who misintroduced Nicola Sturgeon as First Minister. They have misintroduced myself many times in the chamber, calling me, hey you, what's his face, and whoever you are with your hand up. It is so easy to misplace MSPs, I frequently forget who I am myself. ACH, out.
Celebrating 10 years since the release of Grand Theft Auto 5, the new updated edition, this is Grand Theft Eco. Can you steal an electric car from one of the only few functioning plug points in the city?
Oh, that's my charger!
Put your boot down and feel the scintillating revving engine sound of very little noise at all. Can you keep your cool as slow walkers in the fast lane limit you to 10 miles per hour?
Climate change is not a lie. Do not let our planet die.
Shut it and get out my way. I'm trying to start a crime spree here.
Pinch someone's reusable keepy cup. Bang a cop's head off a purple bin. Mow down a bystander on a rechargeable electric scooter. And if you're desperate to experience the exhilarating thrill of debauched lawlessness, at least make sure you're adhering to the city's new low-emission zone.
He's a dangerous perp on a trail of destruction, but at least it's not a diesel motor.
Grand Theft Eco. Criminality with a conscience. Who said a life of crime had to be bad for the planet?
Hello there. I was hoping to talk about this new NHS initiative in Fife, where they're prescribing golf to help cure ailments. It sounds great, but are there any side effects like?
Sadly, yes. You may feel the urge to drive a BMW and park it over two spaces whilst wearing silly trousers.
It might be worth the risk. I'm feeling a bit weak and low at the moment and thought it might help.
Definitely sounds like you have quite a severe 5-iron deficiency. Golf could be for you.
Well, what do I do?
Well, we'll start you off small, mini golf, but we'll need to ramp it up, pitch and putt, and soon onto the real thing, a full 18 holes. And I must warn you that in order for golf to be effective, you must finish the whole course.
Are you sure it's good for me to spend this long playing golf?
Of course. You are far more likely to get a face-to-face meeting with your GP if you're on the golf course.
You're 10 o'clock, Prime Minister.
Good to see you, PM.
Thank you for popping in. We've got a massive security check going on at the Mo, so I need to be sure you are who you say you are.
Of course, PM.
Right. So, who are you?
Douglas Ross, PM.
Right. Douglas Ross.
Yeah, the leader of the Scottish Conservative and Unionist Party, PM. We've met several times before. You landed your private jet on my lawn.
I've landed my private jet on many lawns.
The one with the wee red gnome you crushed?
Oh, yes, of course. That's Douglas Ross. Oh, thanks for reminding me. Forgive me. Where do you represent again? Motherwell? Methil?
Murray, PM.
Moray.
It's pronounced Murray, PM.
Moray.
Say it with me. Murray.
Murray or?
Murray.
Murray. Good. Well, can you bring round two forms of ID and a utility bill with your address on it to prove your identity? We can't be too careful. Spies are everywhere.
No, PM. Pesky, blumping, sneaky, slickets, snoopy so-and-sos.
Right. Some of them are hiding in plain sight.
The clonking, cunning, conniving, cheeky little articles.
Plotting to bring down the government, undermine the UK, and doing it sitting right here in the House of Commons, brazen, on the benches, asking me questions.
Sorry, who, PM?
Right. I've alerted MI5 to suspicious individuals working for something called the SNP.
The Scottish National Party, PM.
So you've heard of them? Fiendishly cunning, Scotch spies under orders from a faraway place, hell-bent on bringing down our United Kingdom. How did the guards even let them in the chamber?
Well, PM, they're democratically voted in by constituents who share their view.
Really? Are you sure?
Yes, PM. Dag Nabbit, blumping gnats have been getting elected for decades. Grr.
Confound it, Doug. Let's torn it so we can't kick them out using anti-espionage laws.
I wish we could, PM. I wish we blumping could.
Remember, two forms of ID and swear an oath of allegiance to the flag on the way out, just to be on the safe side.
My pleasure, my liege.
Right, and give my regards to Melrose.
It doesn't matter. I will do, PM.
Booking that all-important trip to Germany next summer? Paterlingo German has all the vital phrases a Scotland fan needs.
Ja, mein Herr, ich kann boogie tanzen.
Yes, sir, I can boogie.
Paterlingo, all the essential German phrases for next summer and now.
Stefan Clark steht vor dem Job als deutscher Fußballtrainer nicht zur Verfügung.
Stevie Clark is not available for the job as Germany head coach. Pause off.
Updated to reflect recent results at Hampden.
Das England-Ergebnis ist irrelevant. Es war nicht freundliches.
The England result is an irrelevant. It was a meaningless friendly.
This week on Channel 4, the cosiest show on television returns to our screens. That's right, the Great British Bake Off is back for its 14th series. Then, as every hit TV show gets its own US remake, stay tuned for the all-new Great American Bake Off with your hosts, wrestling legends Hulk Hogan and Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Can you smell what The Rock is baking?
Oh, yeah, I'm here with Laquanda. What have you made for us today, sister?
I've made a 3-foot-wide Mississippi mud pie with a volcanic chocolate syrup center.
Oh, hell yeah. Hail to the pie.
That's what I'm talking about. The pudding is going down.
That's the Great American Bake Off, followed by the US remake of Watercolor Challenge.
Fire up the paint guns.
Just before the jazzy trail for the new Strictly series, where the dancers all line up on the staircase looking fabulous, welcome to BBC Reporting Scotland with me, Anne McAlpine. The headlines tonight. There have been huge protests over plans to bring down a third of East Kilbride's town centre. Passionate campaigners led by famous ex-resident John Hannah say they'd rather have the full three-thirds demolished. To mark the 40th anniversary of iconic detective series Taggart, Glasgow Caledonian University has put out a call for all those who played extras or victims to come forward with their memories. Those who played killers will, of course, turn up unexpectedly shortly before the end.
A patch of snow, believed to be the longest lasting in the UK, has melted for only the 10th time, according to records going back more than 300 years. The snow patch had formed on Britain's third highest mountain, Braai Rioch, in the Cairn Gorms. In other news, two entrepreneurs say they're delighted with the profits from their new Braai Rioch pop-up slushy bar. No new offshore wind project contracts have been bought by developers at a key government auction. Not only is this disappointing for the chief executives of the renewable energy companies, it is also the biggest loss ever seen on Bargain Hunt. That's it from the Late Team. We'll be back with the Early Bulletin tomorrow at stupid o'clock, so you'd better zip to your kip ASAP if you want to catch us. Anne McAlpine, reporting Scotland.
Get set for Show Tunes, a toe-tapping, claw-scratching, brand-new musical inspired by those massive rodents spotted in the back lanes of Glasgow. Following in the paw prints of smash-hit West End musical Cats, this is the sound of rats.
Midnight, vermin cover the pavement, rodents screeching on bin bags. What a horrible din. In the lamplight, I thought I bashed a rat on the heat, but a million more scurried in.
Rats features an ensemble cast, belting out numbers themed around squeaky pests the size of furry felines.
Oh, well, I never was there ever. A rat so clever as Magical Mister bites off your knees.
Magical Mister Bites Off Your Knees is featured alongside other vermin-themed tracks from all your favourite Broadway shows.
Do a rat, a female rat, prey upon the spiraling scum. Me, I'm worried for my health. Far so far these rodents run, so they're gnawing through the thread. Lather landing on my toe, teeth they're crawling on my bread, and that drives me to hide. Oh, 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 oh.
Rats, now on general release in Glaswegian lanes, gardens, bins, stairs and houses.
You have been listening to Noising Up, starring Karen Bartke, Stephen Buchanan, Zara Janjua, Lana Faiton and Manjit Sumal. The director was Stuart McPherson. The script was written by Nathan Cowley, Will Murray, Darren Phillips, Garth App Thomas, Christopher Stanners, Matt McDonald, Chris Douch, Wes Fargo, Simon Paul Miller, Mark Granger, Rebecca Bain and Alex Garrick-Wright, Uttam Chowdhury and John Albiston, Paul Brown and Gregor Payton. Noising Up is a Comedy Unit production for BBC Radio Scotland.